Gen AI is useful not just for consumers, not just for entertainment, but for research, for industry, for making the world a better place. It's going to help scientists, it's going to help artists, and who knows, it might even help cure cancer. And for all those reasons, we need to make sure that AI in this new era remains open, accessible, and available to all. My name is Aaron Gokaslan. I'm a PhD student at Cornell University. I do work on generative models, particularly relating to large language models like ChatGPT style text models. My work focuses mainly on trying to open source these technologies and get them more efficient into the hands of more people. A large language model is just a really powerful AI model that predicts the next word. And it lets you do lots of open-ended tasks, including simple ones like answering questions or way more complex ones like solving a math problem. I started out working on these in my undergrad and master's, and actually I did them in the context of images because I was really interested in how we can use these models to help augment the creative process. But it'd be really cool if I could take these ideas I have and present them as beautiful images and pictures without having to master a paintbrush or a pen or a camera. I went ahead and started working on them. They looked pretty silly, but eventually they got better. And circa around 2019, there was a paper that really caught my interest called GPT-2. Essentially, what they did was they took a huge portion of the internet and they fed it into a model that just predicted the next word. And they showed by doing this, you got all this really interesting behavior that you never explicitly trained the model to do. I saw it was going to really just change how we interact with computers. This applies to creative works. It also applies to scientific works. We'll be able to have the power of tens of thousands of people to deploy, to cure cancer, to make movies, to generate beautiful pieces of art. Artificial intelligence is going to drastically change creativity, the same way we thought about computers in the 90s, the internet in the 2000s, and the cell phone in the 2010s. And it's just too important to leave in the hands of a few companies to go and create and research and have all the say in how we use them. Open source is a concept we have in software where the software is uploaded online, anyone can edit it, and anyone can add new features or modify it to suit their needs. We need to have AI that can be used by the individual and can be used for ways that their creators had not even envisioned. And that's why it's so important for large language models, for AI to be open source.
And thank you, Mozilla, for honoring me with this really amazing opportunity and award. It is so great to see open source have its time to shine in our AI era.